Greetings, Diamond Warriors of the new Avalon Rising. Another powerful day of activations and downloads. Before recording this, there was a massive cloud formation starship that looked like a massive dragon in the sky. And the image in today's video from Divine Sistar Suzanne Amara, this image from Suzanne as part of the last dragon code and a very powerful call to remember. And part of these activations, downloads, are this reconnecting, relinking, remembering, bringing all aspects of ourselves back to the center of the disc, the wheel, the medicine wheel, and a powerful activation code was manifest in consciousness today directly from Buddha consciousness, which I will transmit to you now about the virus of the matrix or the false aspect of the construct of the matrix, this concept of ignorance. I'm going to explain a different perspective, perception of this concept of ignorance being part of the virus or the disconnection, the separation programming. And from a higher dimensional aspect and consciousness, ignorance is not something bad or negative. All it simply is, and I'm going to make this as simple as I possibly can in this now moment, ignorance itself is simply to ignore your brilliance, your divine radiance, what Confucius would say or call bright virtue, your true nature. And some of the ways we ignore this is the trickery, deception of the lies of what we may call the bad actors in this realm, or simply those that have forgotten their true nature, their true self. Also, external distractions, which part of the practice of awakening was the mantra, none of my business. And at the end of today's transmission, I will refine the mantra, the code of none of my business. I've been getting multiple comments and emails of questions on this, so I'll address that in this video so I don't have to respond to all of them and to clarify the meaning. So shine on, you crazy diamond. In Taoist, we say crazy wisdom. That is the wild spirit flying freely with the divine wisdom, the ego flying with the condor. Gnosis Sophia. Aho. So today, another powerful day, Kin 73, been coming through all day today. This is the code of heaven on earth, 37 into the 73, on earth as it is in heaven. Also on the Schumann, we had a 27 hertz spike today, which is the 9 energy of completion, manifestation, fruition. We also had 177 earthquakes in the past 24 hours, M1.5 or greater. So encoded in there is the 17, the 77, and the 71. Also today we had a trinity of earthquakes through the sacred Andes Mountains, the Kundalini, Pachamama rising up. Within 3 hours we had a 4.5, 3.5, and 4.1 in Chile, South America. And there were several across this realm, across the Tropic of Capricorn in the Southern Hemisphere. And the deepest, 539 kilometers of, by Fiji Island, a 5.9. The whole ring of fire totally lit up again today. And we're heading into, today is the rising of Venus as the morning star. And as we transition into, so with this Venus morning star rising, as we transition into this powerful solstice coming up in about 11 days from today, will be the second of the Trinity series of eclipses, and it will be the second ring of fire. We've also been having a heat wave through these parts of the states. Yesterday and today, a massive heat wave, and now the thunder beings are here right now. And a massive storm is accumulating. The power is going in and out as I'm recording this. But luckily I have this system on a battery backup. So I should be able to finish this as long as we don't have any major issues. But the wind is really kicking up. And we had and again by the Ascension Islands, just north of the Tropic of Capricorn, a 5.4 and a 6.0. That was the most powerful today, and it was on the 15 degrees south latitude and the 13 degrees west longitude, 10 kilometers depth. We'll get started with today's first transmission from Kej Raj, Homo Christos, the New Earth Human, Inside 5D Earth. The universe is truly one. The light from the great central sun is infusing every star system in the galaxy. Our sun is bombarding each planet of the solar system with a new, refined light. The awareness of the collective of humanity is continuously expanding. The vibrational frequency of Mother Earth is increasing at great speeds. The gates of the fifth dimensional reality for Earth and humanity are fully open. Now we are anchoring a higher part of ourselves into the fifth dimensional matrix. At the same time, through the activation of our DNA, we are pulling up our physical vessels into the higher light. One can say that planet Earth is like a second great central sun, because as it has been said many times, what is happening here is affecting the entire galaxy and beyond. The mission or project is already a success, for humanity now stands inside the doorstep of the fifth dimensional Earth. You have made it. The only thing that remains is the adjustments and a few more upgrades to the physical vessel, because this is, for the first time ever in the universe's history, physical ascension. Hence the reason for this process being so gradual, or so it may seem to many, or the human body would burn out. You are ascending and bringing your physical vessels with you to the fifth dimensional realm, becoming ascended masters without leaving the body behind. You are Homo Christos. So what can we expect as the awareness keeps expanding and the transformations of the body continue? As we become the new human, Homo Christos. The truth is the most important thing to you. You feel complete knowing the truth without accumulating materialistic things. One's love of nature and natural surroundings will continue to grow. You will begin to express more of your healing abilities. You will begin to recall your past lives without error. The need for sleep time will gradually decrease. You are already being drawn to new locations and may feel a push or pull to relocate. This is your soul wanting to be near ancient sacred sites, as these places prepare to anchor the new cities of light. The peace within begins to be expressed in the outer world. The need for judgment of self and others disappears. The change in your diet will even surprise you. You will seek food that is filled with sunlight. A vegetarian diet, your emotions become less intense and more balanced. The idea of the ego is released. You will come to understand that it is nothing but an illusion. These are just a few things to list as changes on Earth pick up speed. As we have said previously, the amount of change we have seen in the last 5 years, we are now going to see it in 1 year's time or less. The being within you has been so patient, and now the time has arrived for the spirit being within to shine like the sun that it is and bring light to the world. From heart to heart, I am Kej Raj. From Divine Sister of the Light, Judith Kusel, our only purpose in all eternity is to be one with and in the light. We must ever expand the light in our individual being and become fully conscious of that being, so that our everything is of and for the light. Each breath we take, if we are conscious, draws light into our being. Every word we speak sends forth light. If each word is spoken in consciousness, every time we focus attention on another being, we are opening that channel of light and a beam of light goes out. And if that being responds in kind, there is a great brilliance. As the Master Jesus spoke, when two or more of ye are gathered in my name, there I am. The two being conscious, for even a moment, connects and creates more of that network of light. Every connection made with every person is connecting those people with the filament of light. Every person that has been truly met and communicated with becomes part of the network. If we acknowledge that we are of the light and working for and serving the light, and that they too have responsibility to be of the light. It does not have to be wordy or flowery. A few words, a few sentences acknowledging the light are all that is needed, and at times all that is required is a touch or a look, or even just seeing someone clearly for an instant. There is great responsibility and there is great joy in spreading the light. Robert Simmons, and this is from JudithKusel.com. From Astro Mama, today, June 10th, Venus, the planet of love, beauty, and pleasure, currently retrograde in the sign of Gemini, rises as a morning star. She has gone to the underworld for the last 10 days to transform. After June 10th and for the next 18 months, she will rise in all her glory as a beautiful light in the early dawn hours. Morning star Venus is more aggressive, masculine, and dominant. She will have us stand up for our ideals and desires in matters of love, money, and pleasure. Slowly but surely, our energy levels will begin to rise again, and we will feel more directed and powerful. Retrograde Venus becoming visible as a morning star reminds us that we cannot avoid the dark to honor our light. In fact, without embracing our shadow, we cannot fully step into our radiant and authentic selves. She reminds us that we all go through dark periods, but these phases don't last. Although our strength to deal with them always will. Venus as a morning star wants you to honor the light within that can withstand any obstacle or challenge along your path. As she rises in the morning sky, look up to her and honor your sacred and loving self. You are worthy and you are so loved. And from the archangelic calendar, Gaia has remained in a spirit-dominant setting. We are not sure what her thought process is, but we know she keeps toying with the notion of moving and then does not. It's an interesting position for her because she seems like the only one holding up what is about to come. The other thing to be noted is that she is very tender and almost wincing in pain, so we assume that could have something to do with it. This is a very nice timeline. I hope we get to stay here. It doesn't seem likely, though, as we jump timelines, like it's going out of style. In perfect synchronicity, the lower density timelines are completely detached, and this is some of the reasons for Gaia's tenderness, but it also guarantees that we will not dip into the lower timelines through these very intense quantum leaps. Dear Moses, you are not wandering through the desert for 40 years. It's called portal hopping. Mainstream science recognizes that there are 4 galaxies sending energy to the Earth, but there is at least 12 on this plane, and an uncountable number of ones on the higher dimensions. Angel wings on the Schumann resonance are part of what we mentioned about humanity knowing the archangels like never before. They will be easing you into this integrated society, but they will not be shy about it any longer. In related news, there are heavy transmutation demon specialists out in full force today. That could mean only one thing. The next macro agenda of organized darkness is a star race invasion, but this is our territory and thus we have full jurisdiction. This means that if they are intending to false flag this, Pandora's box will be shattered. There will be no going back if they force us to flex our muscles. The malevolent star races are well aware that they are powerless against strong metaphysical powers. They are also aware that there are at least 144,000 Christed masters roaming around, all of whom are itching to use their newly found talents. This means that they will tread lightly, but the humans of Ad, on the other hand, may tempt fate. A giant shockwave will be coming from Mount Shasta, and it will be initiated by 2 Galactic Federation of Light starships. We hope to get some video of this upcoming event. As the polar caps melt, new bacteria and life forms will appear. Some will be very helpful, and some are designed to regulate energetic ebb and flow. With the early humans developed their frontal lobe, their animal selves became emotional and thoughtful. Now as we rise to another such burst in progression, changes to our psyche are taking place as well. So the tools in today's assignments are in the link in the description below, and this is from archangelicalendar.com. And from the heart of Buddhism, from Longchenpa, whatever occurs, whatever it may be, That itself is the key, and without stopping it or nourishing it, in an even flow, freely resting, surrendering to ultimate contemplation, and naked, pristine purity, we reach consummation. Aho. From the Zolk'in Times, Kin 73, Red Galactic Skywalker. Galactic is the name for the number 8, and its keywords are harmony, integrity, and modeling. The number oozes peacefulness. Galactic days are great for making music, making up with someone you've fallen out with, and generally restoring harmony in your life. Today is Red Skywalker, which represents exploring wakefulness in space. This day is all about adventures and courage, perfect for doing things you wouldn't normally do. Explore and you shall wake up, free your mind, and feel free to space out, as it is a galactic day. This suggests that thinking outside of the box or doing things in a different way can restore harmony in your life. If you have been struggling with an issue, perhaps you are approaching it using the same old tactics. Expand your mind and try a new approach. And from Divine Sister Christina Papagiorgio, Red Galactic Skywalker, Kin 73, 10 June 2020, Exploring Harmonious Models. 10-6, 2020, equal 10-6, 22, equal 1-6-4, equal 11, equal 2. 10, Manifestation, Authority, Power. 11, Portal, Gate, Polarity. 2, Partnership, Cooperative. 6, Heaven, Christ, Harmony. 4, Form, Structure, Foundation. Kin 73 equals 10. A 10 double manifestation code today. 10-10 Portal. Today the energy is expansive, propelling you to step up as a divine leader and manifesting your destiny. Day 8 in the White World Bridger Wave Spell of Surrender, Letting Go, Forgiveness, Networking, and Building Bridges. Today we are letting go of all that does not serve you in order to open to the expansiveness of the new opportunities that are yours to experience. Tone of Creation, Galactic Tone 8 in the Mental Realm, Action Modeling, Power Harmonizes, Essence Integrity. The galactic tone will influence much mental analysis today. The most important factor is that we model integrity of our thoughts, words, and actions. Our intentions based on harmony through integrity of being. Our plans need to be transparent and for the highest good of our community and planet, for them to hold up in these new energies. Our projects and business models will then serve as a model for others following in our footsteps who hold the ideals of unity, peace, and harmony as a priority. At Tone 8, we have entered a new scale, and we are so proud. We just have to model ourselves for others. We have also mastered harmony at this stage. We are galactic, and don't we know it? The Galactic Skywalker is seeking to model wakefulness through expanding his mindset, opening to new ways of thinking and being to create more harmony in our world. Today's question is, does my divine mission model my expanded and awakened mindset to explore new frontiers and ways of manifesting peace and harmony on Earth? Divine blessings for the opportunities to expand your reach and have a greater beneficial impact on our world. In Lakek Alakin, Christina White, Magnetic World Bridger, Kin 66. Kin 73, Red Galactic Skywalker. Wow, as I said that, it turned this bright yellow hue outside this massive storm. Let me pause this and see what star nations are with us. Wowee! There was the most massive, beautiful, double rainbow overhead. Many were out witnessing this. I told my neighbors that were out, it's the new earth shining through. But of course, you cannot make this shift up. Kin 73, Red Galactic Skywalker. The mantra, the code for today is, I harmonize in order to explore. Modeling wakefulness, I seal the output of space. With the galactic tone of integrity, I am guided by the power of navigation. So divine navigators of the light, with your brilliant virtue and divine grace, we step forth into our sovereignty anchoring in the freedom codes for all humanity. Beloved beings of light, in the comments below, let us know what you are thinking, what you're feeling, what you're seeing, your visions, your dreams, your synchronicities. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe below. Click the subscribe button and a little bell next to subscribe to get notifications on future uploads. And as always, in the description below will be a link to the transcriptions of today's transmissions, or you can visit primedisclosure.com. We archive these. We have over 1,000. I'd like to also thank everyone for their support and pledges on Patreon. Thank you, Divine Sistar Beth Soulfire, for your pledge and your support. If you'd like to support my work and the mission of Prime Disclosure, you can make a pledge on patreon.com/PrimeDisclosure. I'd like to also thank Divine Sistar Betsy for your donation today. Much appreciated. It's getting brighter and brighter outside as it's getting later. These bright gold and yellow hues. I'll try to post a photo at the end. I took of the rainbow, but didn't come out too well, but we'll see what we can do. Now I would like to talk about, refine, and dive deeper into the mantra of none of my business, to hope to transmit more clarity on this powerful code, this powerful mantra. Because training for over 30 years and teaching many light workers, love workers, way showers, warriors of the light over the years, I understand how the mind works. And any concept or practice or teaching, we let people know that to master any art or practice, it's going to take more than a day, a week, a year, maybe 10,000 hours, nobody knows. But the key to mastery of any art or any practice, there's only one thing besides practicing daily or as often as you can. One thing that will guarantee success is to never give up. I know these concepts, philosophies, are easier said than done, but isn't everything really? Just like we say, let us build a house. That was easy to say, build a house. Now go build it. See what was easier, saying you're going to build it or actually building the house. So let's dive deep into this none of my business, because this is multi-level, multi-dimensional. We begin with external things. And I know every concept, any powerful teaching or practice, the mind of the false, the construct of the matrix, is going to try to raise doubt or try to debate or create conflict of some sort to prevent one from practicing. And the mind, in that process of trying to stop you from realizing your true nature, and these are all just tools, we don't get attached to them, but if it resonates with you, practice it. Practice any art of mantra, meditation, prayer, whatever resonates. And use your own discernment at all times and intuition. Your gut knows. So there's none of my business that's multidimensional. The first aspect, external, what people say, what people do, what people think. And let's really address this and look at it. Because the mind will say, well, if everything's none of my business, then if an elderly person falls on the road in front of me, should I just step over the body? That's what I'm saying when I say the mind takes things to extremes. It's no, it has nothing to do with that. Obviously, if a child is drowning, pull them out of the water. An elderly fell, help them up. I can't tell you how many times in life I've carried an elderly person into their home that fell, or pulled a child out of a drowning in a lake or in a river, and it's... We take action when action is needed. That none of my business in these practices are for things, and now this is psychological, philosophical, emotional, things that are outside of your control, which is 90%, 90 to 90% of what we experience in our day-to-day lives. It's not a big deal. None of my business. So what people think, you can't control what people think. Can't control what people do most of the time. We can't control what we think. We can't control what we do. So we start external. And eventually, when we practice and perfect this art and get to a new level of refinement, we turn that upon ourselves. What I do is none of my business. Most of what I do, we take our time. We take our awareness. We stay in the presence. And in that neutrality, in that presence, we take full action. with full congruency. When the mind is in debate, when the mind is in these negative emotions that things outside of our control conjure, they weaken our state of consciousness, weaken our physical body, weaken our mental fortitude, our emotional power, these things. So we say, when we look, and people all the time, they say, well, how can my own thoughts not be my own or be none of my business? I say, that's interesting. Let's look at this. So very interesting. You think and believe that you think your own thoughts? Well, let's prove that you don't. Without thinking, turn off your internal dialogue, stop the thought process, and while maintaining that silence, not thinking at all, tell me what your next thought's going to be. It cannot be done. So even that original thought, where do all these things come from? They come from Buddha mind, from source. So we don't become attached to everything that is changing. That's why everything becomes none of my business. And this is multiple levels of mastery and manifestation. And these tools, such as the mantra, Om Mani Padme Hum, none of my business. None of my business is tangible. That's something anyone can do, but it is very powerful because it is like the concept that Don Miguel Ruiz transmitted in his book, The Four Agreements. Do not take anything personally, because nothing is personal. It is a reflection. It is a mirror. And the none of my business is part of that. That's how we practice so that we activate and take action, a full consciousness, and how we assist the mind in not taking anything personally by making other people's actions, beliefs, even words. That's why we use our word impeccably, our actions impeccably, when we come from that zero-point energy, that neutrality, and making things and activities. Someone asked if there's an injustice done, should I not speak out? No, in that time, you can speak out against the injustice, but it's after the fact. Say you take the action and the results aren't what you had hoped for. We make that none of our business. You cannot go back in time and change that which has happened. We make the past. It is like the concept. It's not the snake bite that kills you. It's the venom that runs through your veins. It's not the action that happened in your past. It's us reliving it in our mind, hoping, wishing, and praying that that past thing change or something out of our control totally changes. And sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. But we activate great change by making these things, these thoughts, these perceptions, these externalizations of internal conflicts, none of our business. And then that, from that neutral point, it will rise up. And you discern what is very important. With an empowered, activated view, one that's not coming from a limited perspective where everything's my business and I must change everything and I'm going to change the world and change everything around me. The world is none of our business, because the world is constantly changing with or without our help. The universe is in a constant state of flux. It would be like you saying, it doesn't resonate that the galaxy rotates counterclockwise, so I'm going to do everything in my power to reverse, and I'm going to spend the rest of my life reversing the water wheel. I want the universe to spiral in a clockwise pattern. Well, it's like you're just looking at it from the wrong side. If you look at it from the top down, it's spinning counterclockwise. From the bottom up, it's clockwise, or vice versa. I don't know. Astral project and go take a look for yourself. So part of this is not taking anything seriously. And that doesn't mean, you see someone beating a child or torturing an animal, you stop them, obviously, in that action. But the mind right now, even in the most still, pure, peaceful state, wants to conjure these demons. And think about the worst case scenarios. We're saying right here, right now, where you sit listening to this, wherever you are, if there's anything outside yourself that annoys you or raises, triggers a negative emotion, those are the things we might begin with saying none of my business. Because it's a weakened state when we transform our pure awareness into the three hells, the angry demon, the frightened animal, or the hungry ghost. And as samurai, in the training of the samurai, we learn to never go into any battle Out of anger or revenge or fear, we wait like a dragon, a sacred dragon that waits in their cave with wisdom and intelligence. Returning to that neutral, still point, the stillness of the sacred womb. And from there we decide, once all things are resolved, what our next act, what our next action will be, with full consistency, congruency, and embodiment of pure light, pure awareness. So this none of my business opens that sacred space. We start, stop the world that was created by man in its duality and its ignorance, ignoring its brilliance, ignoring that which is within and without, the pure light of bliss, the clear light, hiding from the dark, the shadows, suppressing our true feelings, our true emotions, the love that is within, that is cloaked beneath the negative emotions, the bliss that is just beyond the pain and suffering. We let these things go through the sacred art, through the sacred practice, realizing our true nature, that we have always been and always will be, our eternal light, our eternal life, our bright virtue, our glorious radiance that is shining like the most brilliant gemstone. Inch time, foot gem, each moment is worth more than a priceless gem, because the I Am Presence is the eternal now. So step into that power, step into your light, your sovereignty, your divinity. May this clarify and resolve all doubt, all conflict, and all fear that may arise in the mind of humanity. Have a beautiful and glorious day. Sacred beings of light, I love you all. Namaste.